Hey guys, I'm going to give you a little tutorial here on pump, P-U-U-M-P.com. It's a tool I'm working on for retail arbitrage. It's still very limited as to what it can do, but I'm going to be adding to it over the next month or two. And sign up right now is free. There's going to be the prices once I get payments set up. It's not implemented yet, so you don't have to pay anything, but you can just sign up over here with your email and create a password. And then once you do that, you can log in. And then there's projects, which is for RSS marketing. If you have an RSS feed of your store that you want to promote online, I'll show you how to do that in a bit. But what I wanted to focus on for retail arbitrage is finding products that you can sell. So one thing you can do is look up a UPC number. This one's hard-coded here, but I'll remove that so you can just paste in the UPC number. It's got the images. This is the Ring doorbell. It was on sale for $53 during Black Friday, but now it is cheapest price is 120. This one says Walmart 7. That link doesn't work. So this is the next one. It's 121 here. So these are sorted by prices. Got Home Depot 129. What I try to do is buy on these sites and sell on eBay and Amazon. I did get my account suspended on Amazon, so they were saying I was selling fake items, which I'm not sure why they said that, but I'm looking into that. It's the worst time of the season for retail, so they haven't gotten back to me yet. I'm gonna call them again tomorrow and see if I can figure that issue out, but eBay still works. Anyway, this got the price. The suggested selling price is something I came up with. I'm basically taking a 40% profit margin, and that should cover your shipping, your taxes, your PayPal fees, your selling fees. But if you promote the post, that's usually like anywhere from 5 to 10% of the selling price. The shipping is just 5% of the selling price. I know that's not a very good indicator right now because it doesn't take into account weight, but I will have that information in there. I just haven't gotten to it yet. I'll be looking up the weight by the UPC symbol and then calculating that as to what your shipping cost might be as an estimate. So if I were to sell this thing, if I bought it, let's look at Kohl's 129. If I sold it on eBay for 189, I might make $52 profit. Total profit would be 26 after these deductions, the shipping, the estimated fees. So the shipping, you don't have to, you can set that to zero. I might make that a setting because if you're drop shipping from Walmart or Kohl's or Home Depot, they usually give you free shipping anywhere in the US, so. But I charge shipping. I just do UPS Ground, and that covers my promotion fee on eBay. So let me show you what we can do here. So here's a UPC number up here. I've got these links, eBay and Amazon. I'll just demo eBay. But actually, I'm already selling this one, so let me find something else. You can find products here too if you click on suggest. So I'll do like, let's do Apple iPhone 11 Pro case. Okay. And I'm gonna leave off eBay just because that's where I'm selling, and you usually get a lot of results from from eBay. And a lot of it's used, and I only focus on new stuff really when I'm drop shipping. doing this retail arbitrage. So I will run this search again and see like if that product's selling on eBay and what it's selling for. So here's all the products. They're sorted by price. So here's a $658 for this iPhone 11 case. Here it is on Walmart. You want to add it. Choose an option. What is this? I can't read these. Oh, this is the Pro. This is the 11, the Pro, and the Pro Max. I'll do the Pro Max. Add to cart. And then taxes, 59 cents. I have this Honey, gethoney.com, the Honey plugin, which PayPal recently acquired. It'll run through and use all the coupons it knows about. I've got to check out. Oh, it's out of stock. Okay, that item's out of stock, so. Wait a second, let's remove that. Check out. I'll log in here. Deliver Thursday, I'll pick free shipping. Okay. And then this would be where I'm shipping to. I would add the buyer's address here when I check out. So I just want to add it to the cart to get the taxes and the delivery charges so I know what to sell for. So going back over here, I am going to find this item. I need its UPC symbol. So I should put a copy link there. But we're going to go back over here. Let's hit the back button. Okay, so I'm going to search for this. I'm going to go back over here and do a UPC lookup. Click on that. Type in here. Hit go. So I found a few of them. Looks like this is the same one, so they've all got little different UPC numbers. I'm not sure why that is. These are like generic brands that matched on the search. So I think these first two or three are the brand we want to sell. So I'm going to copy that. And I'll make this a little easier. But copy that UPC. Go back over here now. I'm going to sell it on eBay. Click eBay. And it searches, so it didn't find it in here. So let's try the other one. Because I want like a product that I can pull the information from other listings. So let's try this one, eBay. No matches. Okay, nobody's selling this on eBay. So I'm going to go ahead and show you how to do it anyway. But what you would normally do is come through here. I bet if we search for this thing, we'll probably find it. It's probably got a dozen UPC numbers. So looks like this is the one. So we click down here and go sell now. And then I am going to go to photos. I will do import from web. And then the nice thing about this, if you go, this only has one image, so we're just going to copy that image. It puts the URL in there. Click import. There we go. We have our image. Description wise, I'd probably go over here. That's a kind of a terrible title. I might put I'm gonna take some of these keywords. So the title, what was the title we use? So this is coming from AliExpress. I can already tell by this title. Somebody's probably selling it on Walmart because Walmart allows third parties. So I'm just gonna put case. I'll come back over here. So they've got about this item. You want to avoid copying links like that in your description. So I'm just gonna grab everything here and come here. Go back over here. We'll see if this sells. I'll do another video in a couple days. So I'm paying $6.58. If we go back over here, we're gonna look this guy up, go back to this one, do a search, and then $10.98, I'm gonna sell it for $15.37. That's suggested selling price based on, I'll just put 1349. And I got five. I'll put two. eBay will a large package, 1 pound or less. I always charge for shipping so that I can boost the, oh, that's 19%. Shit, that's pretty high. Well, we'll see. We'll see if it sells. I'll just run it for a day or two. So it doesn't like that image. Okay, so I'm gonna come back over here. This doesn't always work. Okay, so copy image address. That picked it up. The one my API returned was not that big, so I'll see if I can work on that and actually pull the images from Walmart. Okay, so there we go. I listed it. Two available, $13.49. I didn't do variations or any of that. It's for the iPhone 11 Pro Max, so. Also, don't have a UPC symbol because I'm getting it from Target and I don't know the UPC symbol. We matched on title. But if you can, always try to match on UPC symbol when you do the searches. Anyway, that's how that works. I'll have more tutorials later. Oh, we can come over here. You can create a project, just name it, give it a name. Like here's my store, and then when you create a RSS feed, you just give it a name. Sorry, I'm looking in the wrong place. Click RSS. I have one RSS feed. If I want to add a new one, I can do it here. If I click show, it has my three articles in my RSS feed. So this makes it handy to post right here. It says post to Reddit, Twitter, Facebook, WhatsApp, LinkedIn, StumbleUpon, Buffer, Pinterest, and Pocket. So if I click Reddit, it just takes me to Reddit and pre-fills the form. I might want to post it in like Deals. Reddit is pretty good. They're pretty lenient on what you can post there. A lot of these forums, the bigger ones, are very tight about posting links unless you're okay, I might be banned from that one. So we'll do iPhone cases. This is just an example. There's not a lot of big. That's got 700 people posted. Yeah. Doesn't like me for some reason. Okay, I'll have to check that out. My domain may be banned. But going on to Twitter. Click Twitter. Post to Twitter. Go to Facebook. If you join some groups, you can pick share in a group. I'm not in any iPhone groups. So I'm just going to share to my news feed. Down here, click that, click post. LinkedIn, I'm not going to post on LinkedIn since it's for retail arbitrage. But I have other blogs, like niche blogs that have articles, and I would definitely post those on LinkedIn if they're like related to tech or anything. Pinterest. That's not working. Why is it not working? Come on. Okay, try Buffer. Buffer only lets you post to Twitter or Facebook, so I'm not too sure what Buffer is actually. StumbleUpon I used to use a long time ago. You have collections. It's been purchased by Mix.com, so these are your collections. It's very similar to Pinterest. So here's my item, and if I click through, it goes here. So this is kind of to help build pockets, the last one. I just do this to try to get some search engine traffic. I know Google likes to see links from social media. So I can't say whether or not this works, but it's just easier than having to post all these things manually, so hopefully you'll find some value in it. And then, like I said, go ahead and join. Free to join. I'm going to be making improvements. The dashboard's empty. There's nothing there right now. It's mostly just RSS feeds with projects and then products. And I'm probably going to let you save products by UPC symbol, so you'll be able to keep track of what you're buying and selling and what you paid and all that. And then have a history of like what it's sold for and stuff like that. That's the plan anyway. Okay. Long video. Sorry about that. I'll post this in a few minutes. See you. Bye.